morning, Lancaster. Welcome to day one of Rose's 2014. I'm Kat.
And I'm Floss, and we will be your LA1 TV morning presenters for the duration of Roses.
Yes, we're so excited to be here for the 50th Roses, if you hadn't already guessed.
There is no better way to kickstart our first show than with our fantastic Roses promo video. It premiered at Campus Fest this year and got an amazing response. If you haven't already seen it yet, where have you been?
So let's take a look at it.
A great video. Credit definitely needs to go to Tom, who spent hours making it.
Yes, the video has caused so much hype around campus, along with the eye-catching campaign posters of our Lancaster captains who've been training hard for the weekend of the sporting year.
There's been boot camps, alcohol bans, non-stop training throughout the Easter break. Let's hope all the hard work pays off when the final scores come in.
Yes, speaking of training, the rugby team have been hugely vocal in letting us know just how much hard work they've been putting in. So let's go straight to our video diary with the rugby team.
Hi, we're here with the rugby lads and here's Spud and Peddler. So, you guys are on the third team, right?
Yeah, that's right.
How's it going?
Yeah, brilliant so far. We've finished second in our league, which means promotion. And we're looking forward to Roses with being back for a week now training. We're starting to come together, pick our squad.
Okay.
That's looking good.
Good. Are you guys excited about Roses then?
Yeah, absolutely. Sixth and final Roses for me. Been in the game quite a while, medical student and all. So this is an absolute must win. Haven't won a single one yet with rugby, so. No more than this one is one we've got to win, and I think with Spud at the helm, I think we've got all the chance really in the third team, and we've got to start the day off well really.
Yeah, good. So in terms of training, what have you guys been doing sort of to prepare yourself for Roses this weekend?
A lot of fitness, but what we're coming into a week before Roses, we're going to start coming together as a team more, practicing our set pieces, our run throughs, and just get our patterns right. So. We know where we're running when.
Good. Have you guys got any set plays or any tactics that you want to share with us?
Top secret, I think.
Yeah, absolutely not. Who knows what you're sure, Pierre, listening?
Alright, well, thank you so much. Good luck this weekend and I hope you guys win.
Cheers, Justin.
Thank you very much, Justin. Yeah, right, second of me.
Hi, we're here with Sam and Elliot. Sam's going to be the first team captain next year, so let's have a little chat. How are you guys feeling about Roses this weekend?
Yeah, pretty excited for it. I think we've got a good chance to win it. It's the best team we've had in a few years, so pretty good chance.
Good. Have you guys been training every day then this week?
Yeah, we've had every day. I think I've had one rest day. Body's in pieces, but it's necessary to get in the necessary shape for Roses. So.
Okay, so obviously less fresher, so you guys are pretty excited about Roses because you haven't actually been to one yet. So are you nervous? Are you psyched? And, you know, are you ready to play?
Yeah, we've had bigger games this year, so although it's a big game, we've had cup finals, so we're ready for it. So we're not too nervous, but absolutely, it's going to be a big game.
Absolute mixture of feelings, isn't it? Like, excited, nervous. Just really sad to see what it's going to be like, the vibe and everything. It's going to be absolutely buzzing, so.
Well, that's it then. Thank you so much, guys. Thank you.
Our very own LA1 team member Justin did a great job interviewing the rugby team. Thanks, Justin.
He did, and we're pleased to see how excited the team seemed to be. The rugby will be a highly anticipated match and will be played on Saturday. The men's first kick-off at 2:30 tomorrow.
And the women's at 11:30 tomorrow. Good luck to you all. So although most matches don't get going until today, we have already got some scores in from the week.
That's right. The cricket scores from last night have come in. And well done, Lancaster, for beating York 96-81.
Lancaster won, bowling York out at 81, so Lancaster take the points.
Well done to all our cricketers.
It's a fantastic result and a wonderful start to the weekend.
Rowing teams have also already competed. Let's take a look at how the teams got on.
York won the majority of the rowing, but really well done to the teams for their hard work. It was an extremely close score.
So how can you keep up to date with Roses this weekend? Apart from watching our live shows, which can be viewed at roseslive.co.uk, don't forget our teams via social media.
Yes, #Roses2014 to spread the word. We'll be reading out tweets as we go, so get them coming in and support your team. So Kat, what's coming up for the rest of the day?
Today we'll have a live stream from the Sports Centre, which will include indoor hockey, ultimate frisbee, and not to forget the huge event which will be the opening ceremony tonight and the men's football.
What a start today will be. But to give you a taste of what we've got coming for the rest of the weekend, here's a video of our last year's highlights. Here we go.
Troublemaker, troublemaker. You ain't nothing but a troublemaker, girl.
You had me hooked again from the minute you sat down. The way you got your lip got my head spinning around. After a drink or two, I was putty in your hands. I don't know if I have the strength to stand. Oh, trouble, troublemaker, yeah, that's your middle name. Oh, I know you're no good, but you're stuck in my brain. And I wanna know, why does it feel so good but hurt so bad? My mind keeps saying, run as fast as it can.
Okay, we're here down at the tennis courts and I'm joined by Dami, who is the men's second tennis captain. Dami, how did you do?
I won 6-3, 6-love. Awesome. Thank you. It was really tight in the first set, but I managed to grind it out. And I managed to do pretty well in the best of matches, I must say. I got lucky because my guy was making a lot of mistakes, but I did what I had to do, and I'm glad I won, so.
And how about the rest of the Lancaster team? How are they doing?
Lee, who's over there, he won his pretty comfortably as well, against a guy who was apparently unbeaten all season, which is pretty decent. These two, Johnny and Chris, they lost. So it's 2-2 at the moment, and there's two matches left, so yeah, it's all in the balance, really.
Would you say there are any particular star players in the team today?
If you want me to be brutally honest, I'd say Lee. I would say myself as well, but I don't want to sound like a massive like ego. Like, oh yeah, I'm the best player in the world.
I'm joined by Benja now, who plays for the York Men's Seconds Tennis Team. Benja, how did you do?
Not particularly well, I'm afraid I lost, but it was a good match, good fun. He was just a bit better on the day, I think.
He had a tough opponent.
Tough opponent, yeah, he's quite a big hitter when he wants to. Not my finest.
And what's your prediction for the end result?
It's going to be tight. I don't think it's like really cliche, but it's going to be really tight. I hope we can pull it out because we're going to have a pretty decent doubles lineup. But anything can happen, so I don't want to say it. And I don't want to jinx it, but hopefully we win.
Thank you very much and good luck for the rest of the day.
I don't ever wanna let you down. at the swimming pool watching the water polo, and I'm joined by Harriet and Heather, who are part of the Lancaster women's water polo team, who unfortunately have just been beaten by York 9-4. Girls, how do you feel?
Obviously we're a bit disappointed, but I think we played our hearts out, and you know, I couldn't expect any more from the team, so for me, I feel we tried our best and I couldn't have asked for any more, like I said.
Yeah, it was a really tough match, but every girl put in everything that they could, and we're going out. The people that have played their last match today went out on a high today.
So is the team going to change much for next year with obviously the 50th Roses in Lancaster? A lot of you leaving?
We've got about four members of the club leaving, but I mean, that shouldn't be a problem. Each year we rake in about 30 new members, so I'm sure we'll find a good bunch of girls to replace those. But obviously, we're going to miss the ones who are leaving us this year.
And how do you think they could improve the game next year? Is there anything they can do in particular, do you think?
I think just practice, just like drill it in, because obviously most people haven't played water polo until they've come to university. So I think when they first come in, we'll just introduce it to them and just, yeah, keep practicing, like I said.
We need to get this Roses passion in from the start, because we've had the last 2 weeks of really hard training, and that needs to come from the beginning of the year next year.
Well, thank you very much, girls, and well done.
With Diana and Kaylee from the Women's Ultimate Frisbee. Right, so how are you feeling about the game then?
It went really well. We weren't expecting to win.
Overjoyed,
yeah,
if I'm honest.
Very, very excited, especially when we lost last year, so we just wanted it a bit more this year, and we had quite a lot of new players, didn't we?
People came through, progressed a lot, improved a lot in that game.
We had about four freshers that started this year, and
we're minus our captain as well. She got injured.
So you did really well despite that as well. That's really good. Recruited some more freshers to the team. That's really good as well. Who's the one to look out for on our Ultimate Frisbee team?
On our pitch, well, there's a guy called Reese, and he's GB Juniors, ex-GB Juniors, so yeah, he's really good. So definitely keep your eyes on him. And sorry, friends are trying to put me out.
We're here with Rachel from Ultimate Frisbee. So, Ultimate Frisbee, is it as ultimate as they say?
Yes. Okay. I think it is. I mean, technically it's called Ultimate Frisbee because Frisbee's a brand trademark, so you can't be called Frisbee, and Ultimate is just what the guys in America decided to call it 30 years ago.
Fair enough.
But it's a brilliant game. It's so much fun.
Thank you so much for joining us today on Good Morning Roses.
Let's hope this year's highlights will show Lancaster lifting the trophy. Head on down to the Sports Centre now to watch the badminton.
Good luck to all our teams playing, and we hope you join us again at 10 tomorrow morning for updates on today's matches.
Bye.